Space Force will get a boost in the right direction from a SpaceX Falcon Heavy, one of the most powerful rockets ever built. It's been a great few months for Elon Musk and SpaceX, with Starship first orbital launch just around the corner. The company's been landing some insanely lucrative deals with NASA. In fact, NASA and SpaceX have finalized a contract that will see SpaceX's Falcon Heavy launch. 1 month after SpaceX's first Falcon Heavy launch in 3.5 years, the U.S. Space Force says that the rocket is on track to launch again next week. Immediately before and after Falcon Heavy's first operational launch for the U.S. Space Force, the Space Systems Command confirmed that the massive SpaceX rocket's next military launch, USSF 67, was scheduled no earlier than January 2023. The military also confirmed that USSF 67 would reuse two of the three Falcon Heavy boosters that helped launch USSF 44 on November 1st. 1 month later, the U.S. Space Force's tone hasn't changed, and the Space Systems Command remains confident that Falcon Heavy is on track to launch USSF 67 less than 3 months after USSF 44. Assuming the lack of a schedule change is intentional, rather than a matter of not checking with SpaceX or other U.S. stakeholders, no change is a good sign. Since the last time the SSC reported that USSF 67 was on track to launch in January 2023, SpaceX successfully launched its fourth Falcon Heavy rocket. USSF 44 was the company's first launch directly into a geosynchronous orbit, approximately 36,000 kilometers above Earth's surface. SpaceX successfully recovered both of Falcon Heavy's side cores, and has likely had enough time to thoroughly inspect each booster and begin the refurbishment process. If data gathered from the launch, landing, or recovered boosters uncovered issues with Falcon Heavy's performance, during USSF 44, USSF 67 would almost certainly be delayed. The chances of a delay are magnified by the fact that USSF 67 can't launch until two of USSF 44's Falcon Heavy boosters are refurbished and declared ready for a second flight. But it appears that even a gap of 40 months between Falcon Heavy launches wasn't enough to make SpaceX falter, at least after working out some pre-launch kinks. SpaceX accomplished a similar feat, launching two Falcon Heavy rockets in less than 3 months, with one pair of side boosters, on the rocket's second and third launches in April and June 2019. The mission that reused Flight 2's side boosters was for the U.S. Air Force, so SpaceX and the military already have direct experience tackling those challenges. In the 3.5 years since, SpaceX has gained a huge amount of experience recovering and refurbishing Falcon 9 Block 5 boosters and slashed its record turnaround, the time between two launches of the same booster from 74 days to 21 days. SpaceX should thus have no issue turning Falcon Heavy side boosters around for a second launch in January 2023, around 60 to 91 after their debut. While preparing one Falcon Heavy rocket to launch USSF 67 in January, SpaceX, at least according to customer Viasat, may also be preparing another Falcon Heavy rocket to launch the first Viasat 3 satellite the same month. Unlike the U.S. Space Force, which recently shipped one of USSF 67's payloads to Florida, Viasat has yet to ship its first next-generation satellite to the launch site, and says that milestone is scheduled for December 2022. That makes a February or March launch much more likely, but Viasat recently told shareholders that Viasat 3 remains on track to launch in the earliest part of Q1 2023. Combined, USSF 67 and Viasat 3 are scheduled to reuse Falcon Heavy side boosters. Each will use a brand new center core, like USSF 44, which was the first time SpaceX intentionally expended a Falcon Heavy booster. Both new center cores are expected to be expended. For several reasons, assembling and preparing Falcon Heavy for launch is significantly more time-consuming than Falcon 9, so there will likely be at least a 2, 3, or even 4 week gap between Falcon Heavy's next two launches. But as long as USSF 67 and Viasat 3 are ready to fly during narrow windows, in early and late January, it appears that SpaceX could launch two Falcon Heavy rockets in one calendar month. SpaceX has as many as 5 Falcon Heavy launches scheduled in 2023, a stark change after more than 3 years without a single flight. In fact, NASA and SpaceX have finalized a contract that will see SpaceX's Falcon Heavy launch and deliver the Europa Clipper spacecraft to Jupiter's icy moon. The moon Europa is strongly believed to have conditions suitable for supporting life. Could this mission discover the first signs of alien life on another world? The launch is expected to take place sometime in October of 2024, from the Kennedy Space Center Complex 39A. The contract will reportedly cost NASA $178 million, which is quite the bargain compared to the $2.1 billion. It would have cost to launch the mission using NASA's Space Launch System rocket, or SLS. It was almost inevitable that SpaceX was going to win this contract. Congress passed a bill in December 2020, giving NASA the freedom to select any commercial space vehicle of their choice. As an alternative launch for the mission, initially spending bills by Congress for NASA were strictly reserved for the Europa Clipper to launch through the SLS. But because of SLS's high prices, NASA requested the flexibility to work with a commercial launch vehicle. So as soon as the bill was passed, NASA directed the Europa Clipper project to cease all plans to launch the spacecraft through the SLS and instead focus on a launch with a commercial company. NASA would then go on to select SpaceX's Falcon Heavy because they were satisfied that it met all the technical requirements to carry out the mission. One of the reasons why they selected SpaceX is because they placed the Europa Clipper in Category 3 for launch services. This means that the Europa Clippers should be carried on a commercial vehicle that has performed at least 3 successful launches. This put the Falcon Heavy miles above competing commercial rockets. You see, SpaceX's Falcon Heavy was successfully flown 3 times, despite not being launched since 2019. Other competing vehicles such as United Launch Alliance's Vulcan Centaur and Blue Origin's New Glenn haven't even had their first launches. Yet the Falcon Heavy is also more efficient in terms of payload delivery. Compared to the other rockets, the Falcon Heavy is able to deliver 63,800 kilograms to Earth's lower orbit. While the Vulcan Centaur can deliver 27,200 kilograms, and lastly, the New Glenn can deliver 14,000 kilograms, and in terms of cost per launch, the New Glenn would reportedly cost NASA about $2 billion to launch with them, and the Vulcan Centaur would cost them about $200 million. So it's a no-brainer why NASA went with SpaceX. It's cheaper, more proven, and far more efficient. The only issue with selecting the Falcon Heavy is that it's slightly slower than NASA's SLS. With the SLS, the Europa Clipper would have arrived at Jupiter's moon in less than 3 years, but with Falcon Heavy, it should arrive at Europa in about 5.5 years after it launches. Lately, the United States government has been putting a lot of faith in SpaceX. The Europa Clipper contract is one of several future Falcon Heavy missions with NASA, the Department of Defense, and private commercial clients in February. For example, NASA awarded SpaceX with contracts to launch the first 2 modules of the Lunar Gateway, and then in April, they awarded them with the contract to launch the Griffin lunar lander. That will be tasked with carrying a NASA lunar rover to the moon. If the launch of the Europa Clipper takes place in October of 2024 as planned, it is expected to reach Jupiter's orbit by April of 2030.